Hi everyone and welcome back. So till now we have just covered the basics, controller, services, pipes, services, all these things are basics, right? In the building blocks also we have covered interceptors, filters, middlewares and all these things. Now another interesting topic is the Swagger module. Till now we were just hitting the request from the postman and we were struggling with that, right? What if we can get a API documentation for our APIs, whatever we have written? So Next.js Swagger is available through which we can write, we can just use basic annotations and we can get our documentation ready. You don't need to write a Swagger spec YML file. Okay, so how can we do that? So we have to install first of all this particular module, Next.js Swagger. So here we have Next.js Swagger. So once that is done, we can create one Swagger folder and we can define basic definitions. Okay, what is our Swagger config? Okay, so here swagger.config.ts. It is very straightforward, just a few lines of code which we define. Okay, so this Swagger interface we can create. This interface will define, okay, the title, description and the tags. Swagger.interface.ts. So same interface we are exporting here, right? Here we have just defined, okay, because every Swagger spec YML file has the title, versions and different tags. Based on that we do the grouping of the APIs, right? Now so Swagger config, Swagger interface, we have to just create a Swagger initializer, so that we will call as a swagger.ts. swagger.ts file will have main code and we will just import this file in our main.ts to do the required things. So here we will have a export Swagger function. Create a document. So we have to import few things from Next.js Swagger. I mean, this code snippet is already available. We can just use that. So here we are going to use create document method. Create document method will just take this application as an input, which is of type iNest application, Next.js application, and it is going to return open API object or open API object it is going to return, and we just going to create a document builder equal to new document builder, and we just need to set some properties to this document builder, like set title, set title. So all these things are there, set title, set description. I will just go one by one. Dot, consider you put some description here. Then we have another method, set title. We put some title on this, so we are actually creating a basic document. And set version of your APIs, which can be 1.0, right? Now you will have many tags created in your Swagger spec, right? So we just go through all the tags which are defined in the Swagger config. Currently we have created only one tag, which is, you can say, task APIs. Simple task is fine. So we just need to loop on to this and we have to build the document. Okay, so it actually looks something like this. So what we are doing is we are going through all the tags which are defined in the Swagger spec in the swagger.config, and we are adding that to the builder and builder.build, and we are setting these options and we are creating the document, right? Now to enable this in our main.ts, this is the main change which we need in our main.ts. We just need to import the document. Let's see here. set global prefix means our, this is the main API prefix our APIs will have. Okay, and we just need to import a Swagger module, create document we already created in the Swagger, config service we don't have. Okay, right, so what we are doing, we are just setting up the Swagger module. What we are saying that on the API endpoint, whenever you hit /API onto this app instance, then we are going to create a document and we are going to publish it. And this code we have written in the create document. We have created the document builder. In the document builder, we have set all these required things, and then we iterate on each and every tags, and we have added those tags. Okay, so we can just try to see how it works. For Node.js already running, we can go to our main.ts. So yeah, global prefix, Swagger UI Express also we need to install. It is actually a dependency. So after that, I think this should be fine, and we should be able to expose this Swagger document on a particular API, like /API. So whatever the microservice or Node.js you are writing, you can have a particular endpoint where you can see, you can expose the API documentation. Okay, just few seconds. Now it should start our server, and you can see all the APIs now have API v1 prefix, right? So I added a global API v1 prefix, and we should be able to see this. So you can see all our APIs. You can execute this from right away. Here you can get all the tasks. Right, so this is nice to have a Swagger documentation for our APIs. And what we did is we just introduced one Swagger module. Right, thanks everyone. So from the next video, we'll try to introduce a MongoDB that will help us to persist the data.